1-2, Mr. Rooster, just testing out there. You guys can see our beautiful racing robots. I don't know who's going to win. We'll find out in about 7 minutes and 30 seconds. So, hey, go ahead and grab something. Take a seat. And I'm just double-checking my volumes, make sure everything's okay. So if anybody wants to chime in there on the chat and say, yeah, okie dokie blokey, I'm all good with that. So until then, we'll catch you in a couple minutes. Awesome. 1-2 sounds good. Thank you, Wise Rooster 69. You are a gentleman and a scholar, and I don't care who says what about you. called Mike Shy right there. She was supposed to say, hi, my dad's almost up and ready to go. Yeah, you want to say that? No, she doesn't want to say that now. Boy, oh boy. Hey, it's your Black Glass. How you doing? Hey, Weeping Ostrich, how you doing? I know you're in there lurking. So, chat, I know you can hear me. You're looking at the screen. Who's going to win? We got a minute to go. Who is going to win in the robot race? I need to know. Well, I always scream, though. That guy's going to win? Which one? The blue, the light green, or the gray? Or the green, dark green? Ooh, Ichabod says the blue guy's going to win. My daughter says the purple guy. Well, there is no purple guy. The one that gets most votes, gray. Wise Rooster says the gray guy. Oops, now my mic is falling. I said the dark green guy in front with the red on his arms. That's who I think's gonna go. Yeah, right in front there. And we got 50 seconds. The blue guy. Okay, she votes for the blue guy. Okay, Weeping Ostrich says the blue guy. Oh, okay. The green with the wheel, with the single, okay, now she changed it to the single wheel because she has to be different. Okay, let's see, we got 20 seconds. Yours is losing. Oh, God, I hate when it loses. Okay, Ken, who's gonna win? You got, okay. Oh boy, who's gonna win? Oh. Yay! I won! Oh! Okay, you gotta get out of the way. You can't be here. Should've went with me. Oh, well. Sorry about that. Well, there you go, everybody. It looks like the green robot won the race. What do you know? Hello, everybody! Good evening. Welcome to Cooking Pellets. I am the Reverend of Barbecue, and you are my faithful followers. Thank you very much. The webcam, the grill is up. It's a little drizzly outside again. Again, in fact, I left the window open today so you can kind of see. I never leave the window open here. I left the window open. You can kind of see the street. Today's weather is partly cloudy and mostly dreary and wet. So a night. And I take my finger out of the water, and then now it's dry. Anyway, so as you can see, we have nothing across from us there. And the only reason I put this down is just cause it makes for a nice backdrop. So good morning. How is everybody? Rigged. It's your bot. It's not rigged. It's your bot says it's rigged. It is not rigged. It's your bot. I had it with a great guess. Come on, dude. I would never do that. Ever do that. Boy, oh boy, I tell you, I was watching you. You were making a KC. What were you making it, Chabot? You were cutting into doing a KC logo. Kansas City logo. Was it Kansas City? It was Kansas City logo. It was really cool. And then you were working on some other stuff. I was lurking on your channel the other day. I think it was last night or the day before. Very, very cool, though. Really nice color glass. So Ichabod Glass does some KC Royals. Oh, Kansas City Royals. Yeah, there you go, Kansas City Royals. So Ichabod does a stream, and he does stained glass stuff. Very cool. He does custom stuff, but he does a lot of other really cool stuff. And you get a chance, go over at Ichabod's stream and like, follow, and see, and watch what he does. Appreciate you coming down here today, sir. Wise Rooster 69, our mod, of course. It's always here, our mod with the most. Thank you, sir, for spending the time here and being all here with us. And let's see. I know Weeping Ostrich is also out there. How you doing, Weeping? Thank you so much for for dragging in here. Appreciate it for swinging by. Hope everybody's got something to... Oh, hey, look at that. I don't have one of those. I got to grab one of those. So, hey, look at that. There's a cup, and it's a little empty. We got to do something about that. I have some grape juice over here. Let me try this. I haven't... I think this grape juice might need to go somewhere. This grape juice has been open for a while. So, let me turn down the music a little because it sounds like it's a little odd. It's not going to stay forever, unfortunately. I'll pull it down a bit there. There we go. It might be too much. Anyway, we'll pull it down a little. So, appreciate you swinging by. We have a bunch of stuff going on today. We have, like, this massive giveaway that we're going to do. And I have not, I have not put it up. I really haven't put it many places. I'm letting the followers know. And as we go through here, we'll go ahead and we'll end up figuring out, you know, what we're going to be giving away and when. But as we go through, I'm going through my list of people that are up. And... And as we progress through the day, we're going to go ahead and do some stuff. We're going to we don't have a giveaway today, but we got a big giveaway that we're doing, and it starts tonight. So, but we'll get into that in a while. First off, we have some we have some shrimp. Let me show you this. We have some shrimp, and they're defrosting. And I got to give you a little pitch of a defrost item here and how to defrost things. So these are now completely defrosted. Oh, I got a little ice on that. And these were flash frozen. And I don't mind that so much. When things are flash frozen, I don't mind so much. When they're flash frozen, they're pretty good. Obviously, you can see these are some big honkers. Here's my thumb, and these things are, you know, about the same size. I don't know what the pound rate is on these. These are 16-20. So you get 16 or 20 of these per pound. So if you ever see a bag and it says 16-20s or 5-50 or it would say 10-12 or 15-20 or 16-20 or something like that, or sometimes they say like 48-58. That is how many shrimp in a pound. So those two numbers usually signify a pound. In case you didn't know that, maybe you do. So anyway, we're going to be dealing with that today. And we're also going to be, let's see if I can get this to reload here. Sometimes we have a little bump. Bump? Did I get a bump? There we go. We got it. There we go. There we go. Hey, thanks for everybody that, by the way, has followed. Appreciate that very much. Hopefully we get some other people swinging in here. What else? So we got a little bit of shrimp going on today. What else did I do today? Boy, I got a whole lot of nothing done. I got to tell you, it has been a long, stinking day. I felt like I got nothing done today. So we had, beginning of the week, we had like Dish Network come out because we had to move a thing, and the guy that put it in worked as a site contractor for Dish, and the Dish guy that came out wasn't happy with him, and that turned into a three-hour headache on Monday where he thought it was going to take 10 minutes, blah, blah, blah. So what else? We got lots of stuff going on. Right? Too many things going on. The world is busy, busy, busy. So again, bumps. Hopefully you have grape juice where you're at or something close. I don't condone the killing of grapes, but I appreciate it when one does. So we also have a and usually I would have put this on. Pardon me, I have things that fell. I would usually put things on. I have not put anything on. In fact, I'm going to do it pretty quick here. In fact, we could probably start. I did a marinade for some steak, and it was pretty good, I thought. And I don't know because I haven't tried it yet, but the marinade I made had just a little bit of everything in it. And I just kind of use, again, whatever I have around the house. Sometimes I don't always follow directions. The wife likes that. The kids don't mind it so much. And I ended up making a marinade with a lot of liquids, which you should do, and not a lot of spice. But the liquids I used were pretty interesting. Not over and above interesting, but pretty interesting. So today I'm gonna show you what I did for the marinade. We also have, when we do these, I might marinate these. I might start off, I'll put the steak on, and I'm going to marinate a couple of those just for something different. And then I think we're going to make a rice pouch to put on the grill, to cook on the grill. I was going to make a scampi, but, and not that I can't do the scampi on the grill, that thing right there, but I don't want to do the scampi on the grill. And I just noticed our kitchen color. So we got four or five of you. I don't know who all's here, but it's your bot if you want, if you're still hanging. If you want to pick out a kitchen color, or Weeping Ostrich, if you want to pick out a kitchen color, by all means, figure out a kitchen color. Tell me what it is, because we always have to have a kitchen. My mic wire is bugging my neck. We always have to have a color of the kitchen. So if one of you, or both, whoever puts up on chat first a color, that's the color, that's our kind of highlight color for the kitchen. So I don't care if you just joined us, somebody in chat over there, which I just noticed that our chat, our regular chat isn't up. Yeah, here it is, but it's not working. I wonder why that is. Orange again. Orange, you glad you did that. Wow. Acid Drain, 18769. Thanks for swinging by. And, I'm going to kill this one. Basala. Basala Coconair. How's that? You guys got to shorten these. You guys are just, you are pushing my analytical possibility to read correctly. That didn't make sense because some of these names don't make sense. So we're gonna call you Basil. How's that? Can I call you Basil, whatever. You can phonetically tell me how to say it, but oh my God, that's a mouthful. Anyway, thanks for swinging by the kitchen. We appreciate that. Orange, Weeping Ostrich, Weeping Ostrich 2. I wanted to make sure. I thought I saw 2. Weeping Ostrich 2. I appreciate that. Let's look. Okay, everybody. So let's all hold our breath, and we're going to see if we can get the color wheel to spin and stop at orange. Here we go. Where it stops. Well, we know where it's going to stop, don't we? I say that every week, but we know it's going to stop at orange, right? Oops. Nope, didn't. Here, blow on it. Get it to move. Oh, there it goes. Okay, let's stop at it. No, there you go. No, we don't want to go. No, where is it going? Oh, it's over, and I think that's orange. Let's kick it up a notch. Oh, there you go. That's orange. Oh, my God, that's so pretty. It almost matches this. This is pretty. How do you like that? Like, if I got on the floor right now, if I got on my floor or underneath my counter over here, I would meld right in. I would blend in so good, I would go away. It would be like camouflage. This is my camouflage color. Love that. Thank you, Weeping Ostrich. Very good, very good, very good. Thank you. Those of you that are hanging around here, swing live away. How you doing? Thanks so much for swinging by the kitchen and the grill. And, we grill, that's what we do a lot of, but we do everything here. We kind of get stuff started right here. And as a matter of fact, let's not grill my keyboard there. Let's take that off of there. And, let's get going. I think we ought to get some of this. Let me put this over here before I knock it over. I think I'm going to go ahead. We're not going to start on the shrimp just yet. Let me get out my marinated beef, and I'll show it to you. I went ahead and did this. I did this yesterday, and I'll give you a quick rundown of what it is. This is just a chuck steak, like a chuck roast chuck steak, but chuck steak. Chuck is actually really good meat. You have to give it a little bit to understand. Oh, that broke down really nice. Oh, that smells awesome. So look at this. So this marinated. Now this is a vacuum bag. We're going to talk about this. This is a Ziploc vac bag, okay? And you can buy this little hand. I got to rinse this out. You can buy this little hand vacuum thing. And they, you know, at best they work. This didn't have a really good seal in it. And let me show you what I usually use to vacuum seal. And the reason I'm going to show you is, I'm going to leave that there. The reason I'm going to show you is because I like marinating stuff. And now that we're getting into the summer months, I like to do bunches of it and just give different flavor profiles to meats and like the shrimp that you see here and just anything. I mean, you can pretty much marinate anything within reason. Chicken, sometimes, you know, I tried marinating some scallops and I wasn't really thrilled with it. They didn't do so well, which I wasn't really thrilled about, but that's okay. It doesn't have to do well. I had something on my finger. It was one of my daughter's hairs, I think. Anyway, so what I have done before when I've marinated, you know, and the best way, a quick marinade is when you can, actually get a vacuum bag and buy a vacuum thing and take all the vacuum out of a vacuum bag, usually through this little hole right here. And that little blue dot, you usually put a little thing on and you pump it out like this. You take the vacuum. It only draws so much vacuum. It's just a nature of life, okay? So then I found one of these, okay? You can hear that, I'm sure. And then I put that on here, which is good, but with liquids, you got to be a little careful. Now, with this, it's got, these are actually pretty cool. The end comes off, so if you get liquid in there, you can clean this end, and here's the other end. So it's kind of cool. I mean, it works really well. For what it's doing, and here, I mean, it draws a pretty good vacuum, but it doesn't draw like that 30 pounds of pressure, the negative 30 pounds of, you know, the actual air release, you know, what that whole outer space thing. It's not doing vacuum like that. It's what do you want for $20 and some bags, please? So and I'm getting to what this giveaway is gonna be. We're doing a giveaway. We're gonna start it tonight. And it's going to go through 2 months. And it's 2 months for a reason, okay? So we're going to get people to follow us. And we're really trying to do it for followers here. We're trying to go. So if you haven't followed, oops, hit that button up there, that follow button on Twitch. So we know if you like us. And we keep doing this. So, but we're not going to do the follow or the contest thing yet. I think Wise Rooster's got the link ready, but just wait. So we're going to give away something really nice in a couple of months, but we're going to let you start putting your name on it and getting chances today, but in a little bit. So anyway, this is what I used, the bag that I use, this little device right here. You push a button, runs on 5 or 6 C batteries. And generally works pretty good, okay? But it doesn't work as good as when I was at a buddy's house and he had this contraption, took all the air out of it, and just made all that good juice stuff go in. He was doing chicken, but you can do chicken, beef, pheasant. I don't care what it is. You can put anything. You can anything. I haven't tried it on rice yet, and I really want to do that to see if I can get the juice in the rice and leave it sit overnight, you know, just kind of. And I want to try beans, too. I know that sounds odd, but sometimes if you can do beans, you know, the beans suck up a lot. I'm not a big bean guy, but if I could flavor the beans, see? Oh, now everybody's going, oh, that's a great idea. Thank you very much. So, anyway, that's why I got this contraption, but what I have, I'm going to give to one of you guys so we can go ahead and figure it out together. And it's new on the market. It's only been on the market. It was a Kickstarter campaign, and it's only been on the market, I don't know, maybe a couple months. So anyway, so this I'm going to put on. This is chuck. This is part of a chuck roast. You can see it's got really nice marbling on it, and it is just smelling so good. So on this, I'm going to tell you what I used on this, and I'm going to put it in front of you so you can see. And it's It's real simple. It was like three or four things. And those three or four things were pepper, some grape juice that's crushed, a.k.a. wine. There's no right amount. I'd say a quarter cup of wine. And then about an eighth cup of balsamic vinegar. And don't buy the expensive stuff. I have 20-year-old stuff over here. Don't use that for this because you won't get that profile out of it. But just a good balsamic vinegar. And then in some Worcestershire sauce. Is that how you say that, G? With some Worcestershire sauce. There you go. So those three things there is what I like. R-E-A-N-N-N-S. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the kitchen. Welcome to the grilling area, which we'll be at in a little bit when we throw stuff on. But thank you, H, for swinging by. Have you smoked a brisket on that thing before? You know, as a matter of fact, acid rain on that thing before, I have done a little brisket. Kind of favor myself as a brisket man. Yes, I do. So I have done a brisket on there. And the way I do brisket is a little different than others. That happens to be a pellet grill, if you have or have not heard. And if you have, I'd like to know if you have heard about a pellet grill. You can do it on a regular grill. The one thing that we tell everybody, if you have a pellet grill, great. That's what we cook on, is a pellet grill. Okay? And if you don't have a pellet grill, that's okay too. It's all about keeping temperatures. Oh, the last thing I did is on this, the first thing I did is also about an eighth cup of my roasted garlic infused olive oil. So just so you know, that's the one, that was the old one, and this is the new one that we made, and it's starting to really get good. I gotta give it a little mix. So every once in a while, you guys, if you made it with me, here's a roasted garlic with rosemary, fresh rosemary in there. And every once in a while, you gotta take the pop top off, and you gotta put your finger over that and give it a little turn so it moves all the flavoring around. So, or just give it a nice shake up. But anyway, I put some of that in there too with the bag and then vacuumed it. So I own a pellet smoker. You are the king of kings, young man. That's awesome. I love that. J-Ray 160, how you doing? Well done, sir. Thank you very much. We try. Thank you. Thanks for swinging by. So acid rain, so I have a pellet grill and we cook on that little beast 6-7 days a week, except when it's really bad. So I'm going to talk while I put this on. I have it set at about 250 right now, 260. I want to get a little smoke into this. And then, you know, while we putz around and deal with the shrimp and throw those on, I'm going to let this cook out a little. It's not super thick, as you can tell. It's not a really thick steak. It's maybe three-quarters, it's about a three-quarters of an inch. Semp67, good evening, sir. How are you? Thank you for swinging by. We appreciate it, as always. And a good evening to you. Anyway, so back to brisket. Let me throw this on while we talk brisket real quick. So I usually, when I do brisket, I cook it, depending on the size, you know, if I do brisket, I'll have it on for X amount of hours. Like I just did ribs the other day. It was a 3-1-1. But the middle one is wrapped in foil. So, oh, hey, how you doing? Hey, funny meeting you here. What's new? Hey, look at that. Oh, that is a well-seasoned grill. I love a well-seasoned grill. So we are going to plop this on direct. And nothing else on there but the juices that we had from our vacuum bag. I don't want to put no other salt and pepper. All that other stuff that was the Worcestershire is pretty salty on its own, and you don't really need much more. So the brisket. So I go ahead and I'll cook the brisket. Depending on weight, I like to get it to around 195 or 200. It's not a time thing with me. It is a temp thing. So when I hit it to around 180, okay, when I get it to around 180, what I try doing is wrapping it in foil with some liquid, generally a red wine, maybe a soda, maybe a root beer. Depends on what you're looking for, but something different. And I tent it, okay? I don't know if you guys tent, but anytime I do ribs or anything else, watch. Don't notice the man in front of you. Just watch the towel. So when I tent, let's say I'm taking a piece of brisket and I put it in here. And it's sat on for maybe 4 or 5 hours already, okay? And it's not big. Maybe a 4 or 5 pounder, but it's on for 6 hours or so. And we're at 175, 180. I go ahead and I take aluminum foil, and I don't fold it over like this. I go ahead and I wrap the tops, okay? And then I make a tent out of it. And I fold the top over, and then I get the sides over, and I get it nice and tight, okay? So I seal the top, and then I seal the sides. So all that steam, and I put liquid in there, by the way. I put, like I said, some kind of liquid in there. You know, for an hour on a grill, any kind of grill, the temp again, around an hour at 225 with about a half a cup or so of liquid, works out really good. Okay, for about 5 pounds. There's no right or wrong way. You can't put too much in it. So chill. It's don't worry about, oh my gosh, well, how much did he say? Oh my gosh, I don't know what to get. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just, you know, it's about a half cup for, you know, 5 pounds of meat. You know, I did those beef ribs the other last week, Saturday, I think. Oh my God, were they good? So very, very good. So, Acid Rain, thank you for following, by the way. We really appreciate that. And the rest of you follow if you haven't. So, anyway, so that's how I do brisket. And then at the end, I take it out. And just to firm up, like if I'm going to baste it with some barbecue sauce, I'm not a big sauce guy. So I generally don't do that at the end. I don't do a barbecue sauce at the end. But if I'm bringing it over for family, I will put barbecue sauce on the end. The last hour out of the foil and go from there. And what ends up happening is it gets so dang... and sometimes it doesn't take another hour out of the foil, but you got to test it. I pull it at 200 degrees. 200 degrees is when I pull it. If you hit it and it's an hour in the foil at 200, all well and fine. Depends on the fluctuation, how much you got going on, temperatures outside, inside, you know, all that stuff. So, Acid, you're asking, how many hours does it usually take you? I did 13 hours. I don't know. Wasn't super tender. Was sad. Yeah, well, here you go. So... Acid, you're asking me, so how many hours? You know, I do about a 6 hour, but did you wrap it? And here's a little secret. If you get a piece of meat and you know it looks a little rough, and, you know, not all meat is the same. So if you know that meat looks a little, you know, a little fibrous and stuff, you got to get it up to that 200 degrees. Chemical barista, sir, how are you? Thank you for swinging by. Appreciate that very much. Good barbecue doesn't need sauce. Good barbecue doesn't need sauce. What? Okay, I get that. So what I'm telling you is, thank you, Chemical Barista, for that input. So Adrian, what I'm telling, or Acid Rain, what I'm telling you is, you got to get it up to 200 internal. And I don't care how long it was on. If you had the grill at 180 and you never passed up that 200 mark or got up to it, the connective tissue start breaking down in any meat. Like if I do pork shoulder, I do it to 200. And yeah, a 10-pounder takes me 12, 14 hours. But you got to break down that internal fibrous tissue and connective tissue. And that happens between a 175 and like a 190 period. And when you hit 200, you know it's pretty much done. So again, I'll ask you, what did you do it at? What was the temp you did that meat at? Lastly, what you can do, and this is always my best secret I can tell you, is save that last hour. Go ahead and crisp it up, but save the last hour for the wrap. If you have to go somewhere, go ahead and get it up to 200 degrees in the foil the last hour. Make sure it hits 200, and then keep it wrapped. Put it in a small cooler to transport it, and then make sure you give yourself about an hour to serve it. And leave it in a cooler, wrapped. Towels on the bottom, the meat, then towels on top. Doesn't have to be tinted at this point. And then leave it sit in that cooler. It won't lose a degree of heat. I've done it for 2 hours, 3 hours, and that thing was smoking hot when it came out. But it was super juicy and just fell apart. So for what it's worth, and hopefully that worked for you. Time is weird for those shoulders. That small ones take 15 hours. Big one takes 8. Yeah, Ichabod. And Ichabod, I think you said you had a pellet grill. You have a Green Mountain. So, hey, outsider, how you doing, pal? Thanks for swinging by. We appreciate that. Thanks so much for swinging by, saying hi. Glad to see you. Ichabod, I know, has a pellet grill only because on his stream we've talked about it. And that's why I know. So there. But I agree, Ichabod, but I think the reason for that time differential is pork shoulders, not so much brisket. Sometimes depends on the fat cap. If you go to our new website, I'll have it. But actually, I'm going to show you a picture of one that took longer than I thought on our it's on our new website. And it took longer than I thought because not this picture. Wait there. Let me pop it over. That right there. If you can look past this stuff, you see that pork shoulder? That shoulder was about an 8 pound. Oh, get out of there. That pork shoulder was about an 8 pounder, and that had a skin on fat cap. It was a beast thick. I mean, that thing was just something else. Super, super thick fat cap. Probably, no kidding, it was about 3/4 of an inch or so. And I went ahead and I cut through it. I did that cross cut on it just for something different. And I rubbed stuff on it. And it was pretty interesting. Now that fat cap, you know, you always take the fat cap off. I don't like fat. But that was a skin-on fat cap. Very different. But still, it was awesome. But the point I'm trying to make is that didn't have a lot of other fat on it. So if you get a pork shoulder and you know that it's got a lot of fat in it or gristle, it's going to take longer to cook out. So maybe that's the reason it's about for the different time levels. So for what it's worth. Anyway, so let's get to this. Let's get to these. Now, generally, I'll tell you a little secret I didn't finish here. And let me pour off this little bit of juice from melting. So what I was going to tell you is, if you guys have a cast iron griddle, that's what this is, a cast iron griddle, they are awesome defrosters. You get anything that is solid as a rock, you know, and you put it on a cast iron skillet or a pan like this, put it on the stovetop. Don't put any heat on. Just put that frozen thing in there, and it'll defrost like toot sweet. It's amazing how quick that goes. It gets done really super quick. So these, I think we're gonna peel these. Let me get a little water in here. We're gonna peel these, and then we're just gonna make a quick marinade for a couple of them. And we're going to use our old marinade technique. And let me get some water in here. We're going to use our old marinade technique. And what I mean by that is, in this bag is, we're going to use a vacuum bag and our old vacuumer. And it takes about 5 or 10 minutes to marinate shrimp. Shrimp don't take much. And they cook really quick, too. And even though these are some big dogs, they'll still cook pretty quick. And what else I'm going to do, I'm going to try doing some rice, a flavored rice on the grill. And we'll see how that goes. So the only reason I'm going to use this is it just makes it a little bit easier. Now these shrimp were completely frozen, and now they're not. And I like to use a little water because it gets the rest. And you know what, I'm going to try leaving the tail on just for a little bit of present, or not or not. So these are really nice shrimp. They don't smell, which is a good sign of fresh when they were when they ended up getting frozen. So you can always tell fresh fish by its smell. So And all I'm going to do is just kind of de... these are already... I bought these deveined, cut back, deveined. And they already have... like I said, the veins taken out. You can see they're already split. They're very clean. So, which I like. I like when they're clean. That really makes a huge difference. So, there we go. And I'm going to end up drying these in a paper towel. I just want to get this stuff off first. And usually I don't like doing this, but sometimes with shrimp you have no other choice but to do it. And like lobster, I have to do lobster one of these days for you guys. My wife likes coconut. Mrs. B likes coconut shrimp. And I like coconut shrimp. I haven't done it yet. And coconut shrimp needs to have a little bit of extra TLC other than the grill. I'm not saying I can't do it on the grill. We actually have I think we have another grill coming. And, we have a special guest next week. Did I mention that yet to you guys? You guys got to stick around for this. I got to ask, how many of you are Packer fans? I know some of you aren't. You don't have to be a Packer fan, but how many of you are Packer fans out there? By a show of hands, or you can chime in the chat. Little Billy, I see, is a Packer fan, and Sally Mae's a Packer fan. Okay, awesome. So, Rageman, 1, 2, 3, 4. How are you today? I put the wrong thing over there. How you doing? Thanks for swinging by. Appreciate it. Welcome to the kitchen and the grilling area and the prep area and the stream, man. Appreciate that. Packers. Oh, Ichabod. Please, dude. Oh, my gosh. Boo. Okay, I know where you're at. I'll say you're outsider. You don't even know football. You're up north there, right? You guys don't. It's not even cold enough. Packers are good. Thank you, Weeping Ostrich. So anyway, I don't know if you guys remember back and I'm going to date myself here, but the 97 Super Bowl, 97 Super Bowl was the Patriots and the Packers, and I was actually there. I brought my dad to a Super Bowl, had a blast. I was actually there for business, monkey business. But I was there for other business, but ended up going to the Super Bowl, watching the Packers win. And I happen to have a pal that is a Packer, and he is mostly known for his antics on field. During his time with the Packers, they called him the Gravedigger because he's a big guy. And he would go ahead, number 93, would go and tackle. I think he played with the Packers up until 2006. Anyway, he would tackle, and then after he tackled somebody, he'd do one of these. He'd dig in, and he was digging him a grave. And that's why he got the moniker the Gravedigger. Good old Gilbert Brown is going to be with us actually next Wednesday, a week from today. Gil's coming in. He's cooking with us, so which is very nice. Gil's a good guy. We'll talk about his charity. We'll talk about a couple other things. We'll see how he likes to cook. He's got a pellet grill. I've known Gil for, I don't know, 15, 20 years. Great guy, though. And so he's going to come in. And I'm gonna have to be over here like this because he's big. He's gonna take up a lot of room. Actually, Gil's been on a diet. Gilbert lost a lot of weight. He's looking very good. But so we're gonna be doing that. I think we're gonna do a Steakzilla. Huge steak. And I think some chicken and maybe some other. I don't know. We'll find out. We'll see what's going on. So that's what's going on next Wednesday. Gilbert Brown, former Green Bay Packer, Super Bowl winner, Packer Hall of Famer, will be in the house with us, which is awesome. He likes to cook. His kids love to eat, as does he, as do I, as do mine. So I am in New York. You're in New York, outsider. Really? I thought you were on the other side of the curtain there, over on the Canada side. Maybe you're not. I forgot that. Maybe I'm confusing with somebody else. Ichabod, you like the Raiders.
Shark.
Sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. What? Kidding. I'm kidding. Oh, my boy just gave me a hard time. I'm kidding, Ichabod. That's all right. You know what? It's not all about who you do or don't like. It's about the fun you get to have watching them. So, anyway, so swing by if you can, and we're starting to put that up on the thank you, Ichabod. We'll put that, share it with friends and stuff. You like the Packers, and, swing by next week. So, okay. So, we are just about done with doing what we're doing here with that. And let me get two of these that I can vacuum real quick. So, that way, if I shut up about stuff going on and get some cooking done, it'll probably make you guys a little happier. So I want a little bit different flavor on these, and I'm taking some of the moisture off because I want some of the flavor that I'm going to do with the marinade. It's only going to take a couple minutes. I want to get some flavor from the marinade in there. So what goes good with shrimp? Well, let's see here. Let me look. This one I don't really have planned out too well. I think I might want to put some sweet heat. What do I have here? Lemon garlic. Oh, I like the sound of that. So we have some lemon garlic here. And I'm going to go ahead and put some of this in there. And it's just a couple of shakes. This is mostly granulated garlic, lemon crystals. This is from Carbecue seasonings and rubs. And here, I'll show it to you. He does a really nice job of stuff, if you can see that. Does a good job of stuff. Anyway, so we're doing that. And I want to make sure we have a little bit of liquid in there. And not a lot, but a little bit. And since we're going on the garlic end of things, and this will help when we put it on the grill, I'm going to use some of our roasted infused olive oil, rosemary roasted infused olive oil. And I'm going to drizzle it in here, and I'm going to make enough so we get a nice paste from the lemon garlic that's in there. And I'm just going to coat these, and then we're going to put that in this vacuum bag, and then we're going to draw a vacuum on it. Okay? So, and while I'm doing this real quick, oh my God, that smells so doggone good. Okay, cooking. Okay, yeah. I got to open this bag because I didn't ahead of time. Okay, there we go. So a little bit of liquid in there. You don't need much. And they're all completely covered. So, and I don't know, do you guys do shrimp much? I'd like to know that if you do shrimp a lot. I love shrimp. And the kids don't dig it yet. Sometimes they don't. But that's okay. So, and do you guys have any kind of vacuum device? How's that? Do you guys use a vacuum sealer? I need to know if you use a vacuum sealer. So, going back, a couple of tablespoons of the olive oil. You can use whatever you want. A couple tablespoons of olive oil, and then, come on. Trying to get this to suck the air out of it. Bear with me. Okay, let's try getting more out. This is why I don't like this thing, because it's very, it's not a perfect science. There we go. Let me take all the air out, and I'll show it to you guys. Okay, so you can tell. It's the air's out of it. You can tell. So we're just gonna leave that sit. Okay, so that's a pain, but it works. But for $20, what do you expect? So we're gonna leave those right there. These, now what I'm gonna do
Let me rinse this out. I'm going to do something a little different with these. I'm going to make a couple barbecue and then a couple something different. I don't know what. So let me clean that out. A vacuum sealer does. My daughter loves it, but I don't like it. Okay, Ichabod, why? I'll get on to you next, outsider. What does take the air out of the bag do? Okay, so Ichabod, chime in here while I talk. So, and not about what it does. I'm going to explain what a vacuum sealer does. So a vacuum sealer, what it does is two things. If you have foods that are porous, okay, meat's porous, chicken's porous, pretty much any kind of bird is porous, beef is porous. And what I mean by that is if you put a chunk of meat inside a vacuum with liquid, it helps draw the liquid into the meat, because what happens is the air in the meat will be pulled out and the liquid will be pulled in. Got it? So what you end up with is some really well-flavored meat internally. Okay, so it actually will flavor the meat from the marinade. Instead of just sitting in marinade, the marinade gets sucked into it. So it flavors a little bit better. The shrimp, it's still kind of porous, believe it or not, just a little bit. So, and it doesn't take much because there's not a lot to shrimp as far as taste. So it doesn't take a whole long time to do it. The other reason you would want a vacuum sealer is, and Ichabod, you can tell me why you don't like it, but your daughter does, I think is what you said, right? And my daughter loves it. You do not. So why do you not like it? Why does your daughter love it? What the other thing you can do with it is, let's say you caught this shrimp, okay, and you wanted to put it in the freezer. Well, if you take it, put it in a bag or a sealed device, draw a vacuum on it and put it in, you're going to get it to last five times longer, pretty much. Inside the freezer, it lasts for a long time because you take away anything that would get into it as far as going bad, mold and otherwise, because you're pulling all the air out. So, and nothing can live in a vacuum, including mold. So, I mean, it can happen, and this isn't a perfect science, but it makes things last a lot longer. So if you have something you want to last longer, marinate, you put it in a bag. You draw a vacuum with a device. So there you go. That's why we have vacuum sealers. Pretty much any kind of meat that is cryovac or that you buy in the store that looks like the plastic is sucked right into it, that's cryovac, or that is a machine that vacuums it out and then seals around the meat. So makes the meat last longer on the shelf. And at home, it just makes stuff that you're doing last longer. So if, let's say you cooked 10 pounds of pork shoulder or 20 pounds and you wanted to keep half of it for 6 months down the road or a couple months down the road, put it in 1 pound jugs and throw them in a freezer and you'll never get freezer burn or anything out of it. Fish, it's great on fish. So that's the end of my commercial. There you go. And Ichabod, I mean, he was making a store freezer, extra meat. There you go. Grew up locked in a whole life. Any seafood I eat here is opposite of fresh. Okay, yeah. Well, I get that. Ichabod, I'm with you on that. I did not grow up next to the ocean by any means. And here, a real-life vacuum sealer that I can use on myself. I want to live a lot longer. Now, outsider, that's a complete different story and a whole lot more different show. But thank you for sharing, pal. I get it. I believe, but you'd have to be in it the whole time. You, everything. You can't have a little thing to breathe. Yeah. You're in it. It's not good. Okay, so a couple of these, I said we're going to go ahead and turn into barbecue. So we're going to make a couple barbecue. And, of course, this is easy. Shrimp, of course. You got barbecue sauce. Most everybody has barbecue sauce. Give it a little shake. All I'm going to do is put a little here just to coat the shrimp. And we're going to have barbecue shrimp. And that should probably do it. I think I just made a mess all over. Let me go ahead and just put two shrimp in here. So, obviously, super, super simple. Super simple. And I like, and the reason I like getting my hands dirty, because there's nothing better coating of any device than your digits. So, and yeah, you could put this in the vacuum sealer too. I mean, you can put anything in the vacuum sealer and help to get more into it. I mean, there's no doubt about that. So, okay.
15 viewers. Wow, Tasty Morsel. How you doing? Thank you so much for hosting. Arparta, how you doing? Nice to see you. Generally, sir, I see you cooking. I think Arparta, you have a Patra. Arpatra, you, I think Arpatra, you have a, how you doing? Thank you so much. thank you so much, Tasty Morsel. I hope your stream went well. She's a streamer, and she just hosted us, gave us a little raid here. Thanks so much for the host. Appreciate that very much. Chef and Awesomeness. Oh, I like that. Chef and Awesomeness. That sounds cool. Tasty, thank you so much for bringing everybody over. I really appreciate that. Tons. Arpatra, you have a stream, I'm pretty sure. Just reply that you do. And if you do, I think I know who you are. You're up in Canada. Chef and Awesome, appreciate you swinging by. Hi, everybody. Hexero, hi. Wow, everybody's swinging over. I really appreciate that so much. Tasty Marshall, thanks so much for swinging in. Got a little steak on the grill, that thing right there, which now it's dark out. I got to get another light on it. But what else are we doing? Hoxor, hey, how you doing? Welcome to the kitchen. Everybody, welcome to the kitchen and the grill. We do grilling, really. And I got to go out and move my steak. I just got to check on the steak, make sure we're doing okie dokie out there. I got some shrimp we're going to put on in a minute. We have some shrimp that we have marinating and in a little vacuum bag. And we were talking vacuum bag. Sunshine. Sunshell, 1974, how you doing? Thanks so much. For those of you that were with me and haven't seen Tasty Morsel, by all means, swing by Tasty Morsel's Tasty Morsel. Oh my God, I got to have more wine to straighten me out. Swing by Tasty Morsel's stream and see what she's done. And Tasty Morsel, what did you make tonight? I'd like to know. Steak. Yeah, that's what we're doing, pal. What else? U.S. Firefly. USS Firefly, how you doing? Appreciate you swinging by. All you guys, oh my God. Tasty Marbles, there you go. Whatever. Don't give the old guy a hard time, please. I really haven't had enough grape juice yet. That's the problem. So bear with me. Bumps to all if you haven't. Thank you so much for swinging by. If you haven't yet, chat, say hi to everybody at Tasty Morsel. Everybody at Tasty Morsel, say hi to chat. And thank you all for coming in. I appreciate that very much, Tasty Morsel. My chapeau off to you for bringing everybody over. Very nice. I have to go and check my steak marinated, 24-hour marinade, in a vacuum bag. Tasty Morsel, do you do a vacuum bag marinade ever? Do you ever do that? Let me show you what it looks like. Looks the same. All we're going to do is take it and give it a quick flip. Whoa, that is beautiful. We're at 260 on the grill, and we're at 260 because we want some smoky flavor on that. Even though we marinated it for 24 hours, we want to get some nice smoky flavor on that. So that's where we are there. We're almost done marinating this. We have barbecue shrimp here, and these other shrimp, what can I do with those? Well, I am going to use a salad dressing on these. This is Newman's Own. And again, I try using stuff that I got sitting around the fridge. Pasta carbonara tonight. Oh, that sounds awesome. That sounds really, really good. USS Firefly. Yeah, I kind of figured you came from Tasty. Thanks so much for swinging by. Patra. Oh my God. Why am I having a hard time with that? Arpatra lives in Canada. And I watch you stream occasionally. In fact, I lurk. You were streaming the other day making some stuff. And I lurk and I watch you stream. And I always ask you what wine you're drinking. That's usually me. In fact, I asked you about Chianti, and I don't think you had Italian Chianti. But you do a great job streaming. So if you guys want to go up there and take a look at what is going on with his stream, another cook, great cook. I'm a griller. I'm really not a cook or a chef. I'm just a grill guy. That's what I go by. And while you guys are all here, you know, we touched on it earlier. We are giving away a device that we're going to actually open up. We're going to unbox a device today. We're going to give it away in 2 months, but we're going to open up the contest tonight with my followers. Okay, so anybody that's on right now, you can go to cookinpellets.com. The link's right there, and it's /contest. And, you can go to that link. If you just go to cookinpellets.com, you got to go to the catalog and then contest. But if you do that, we're giving away a VacuVita. It's a new vacuum. It's a new vacuum device that was on Kickstarter and stuff, and they raised a bunch of money. They got it out in the marketplace. Only been released about a month or so, if that. And we actually have one that we're going to unbox here, but we have a brand new one in the box, unopened, that we're going to send one of you. Right there. Yeah, one of you guys is going to get it. The thing is worth about $400 retail, actually. So, and we're giving it away. Yes, we are. So, tell your friends, tell your family, tell your enemies, whether you like them or not, and when it shows up at their doorstep on your enemies, steal it from the front. No, I'm just kidding. Don't do that. So, you guys need to go see that. Hexoro, I'd love to see your grill. I'd love to see that. Why, two prime ribs on a pellet smoker. I left them in the smoker setting for 2 hours and turned them up slowly as the day went on. Oh, my God. I bet that sounds awesome, Hexoro. See, that's what I'm talking about. That sounds awesome. If you haven't tried, we do pellet grill, of course. That's what that thing is, which I was going to adjust the light. Now I got to do it. And we actually use, of course, this is cooking pellets. I am the Reverend of Barbecue. And we use, on this today, I actually have our hickory pellets on. And we generally use our either our perfect mix or our hickory pellets. And our hickory pellets are a 100% hickory, okay? There's no fillers like oak and alder in there. So cookinpellets.com, go there, take a look-see. But enter the contest because I want one of you guys to win. Honestly, I really do. So go to cookinpellets.com/contest. And after this, you got the link, just set it up on another thing and do it. So that's awesome. I think I did it right when it's, I hope I win. Me too. Yeah. Sunshine 1974. I don't know what link you tried putting up. If you let me know, I might be able to allow you to put a link up. If you threw a link up there and, now permitted for 3 minutes and one link. Okay, so you got 3 minutes. Thank you so much, Wise Rooster, for allowing. Wise Rooster 69 is our mod with the most. He takes care of the incidentals back there. Thank you so much. Ever smoked some bacon? You know, I got to tell you, Chef Awesome, you missed it. I did a bacon show. I did a whole bacon thing. We did more bacon than Bacon's Got Bacon, and then we did some bacon. So I did some smoked pancake, bacon pancakes. Everything I do is on the grill. That thing right there. Actually, we got another one going on the deck because we need more room because we got some other stuff coming on. So I do bacon. I do a lot of bacon, but I do it on a thing we like to call frog mat. I don't know if this, does this look familiar to you? This is a cooking mat that we use on the grill. And this is frog mat. And I cook bacon on this. Because I can take just good old bacon, throw it on this. I don't have to turn it. Takes about 20 minutes at about 50, and it's perfect. Maybe a little bit less time. Maybe a little bit more. Depends on how thick it is. Never smoke. Yeah, she's cooking. She will be right back. Sunshine. Oh, okay. Awesome. Then we'll give her another 3 minutes when she comes back. Let her know, Wise Rooster, if you can keep track of that. I appreciate it. Making bacon pancakes. Yeah. Not today. We did earlier, though. We did... that was on a previous show, and mentioning that, if you guys, let me skew some of these up so we can get them on the grill while I'm chit-chatting here and talking and wasting time. What we need to do, and we got a big announcement too, a follower that we're going to have in here. Just before you guys came in, we made the announcement, but I'm gonna retell you guys, so don't go anywhere. I am going to put, to skewer these so they don't flop around, I put one through the tail. And one through the top, the fat, and you see that. And the reason I do that is they lay a lot better on the grill. So anyway, I use the frog mat to put on my grill, and I go from there. What kind of grill you got there, Hexoro? Do you have heat for the bacon to cook in 20 minutes? How high? It's only about 250, 300. It depends on your grill and the temp outside, but 250, 300 degrees cooks it in no time flat, really. It does. It does really good. And you got to play with it with your grill. Your grill, it might be different than my grill. So I tell you, test it. But go, you know, start at like 300 and check it after like 15 minutes. And if it's your liking, pull it off. But that's where I would start at. On Saturday. There you go. And hey, we're here on Saturday, just so you know. We're always here Wednesdays. You know, always go by Tasty Morsel and catch her stuff. But we're here when she's done. We start around 7 o'clock Central Time on Wednesdays and 10 a.m. Central Time on Saturday mornings. So if you want to swing by then, that'd be awesome. I'm going to give these barbecue ones its own skewer. And then I'm going to take the ones out of the vacuum bag and go from there. You're like a 90s salesman. I'm sorry. Is that a bad thing? Come on. Do it. Why am I a 90s? Wait. Why do you say that? One daily best. Why do you say I'm like a 90s salesman? Is that good or bad? Come on. Curing for a week. Applewood. Oh, nice. Nice, very nice, Chef and Awesome. That sounds good. F1 Shine 13, thanks for swinging by. I think I got that right. Too many letters and numbers in that F, so, but I like it. I'm here for the cringe. Okay, there it is. Well, I appreciate anybody stopping by for whatever reason very much. You kind of put a half-sized cow on it and rotisserie it. Oh, yeah, I'm with you, Herox. I'm with you. I can't find the contest. Dude, okay, so the link was just up above. Outside 97, the link was up above. Scroll back through your chat, okay? And it's cookinpellets.com. If you just go to the website, not the one that I just showed, our old website is still up, cookinpellets.com, and then it says catalog. Click on that. It's the second one down underneath our premium wood pellets, and you'll find it, okay? The rev, the link is 44. Maybe I got a bunch of... Hold on. Let me go find out what's going on. Maybe I got too many people on it. Maybe we got too many people on the link. Don't go anywhere. Let me check out and see what... Let me see what's going on, peeps. Here, you guys hold on a second. Let me put some shrimp on, okay? Oh, let me do these too. So these were our marinated. Let me click on contest. And I got it. It's up. Let me go ahead and post it. Let me copy. And let me put it in. Bear with me. Let me put it up, guys. Bear with me one second, okay? There we go. Okay, this is the post. This is the link for the contest for the vacuum sealer. Oh, my God. That's garlicky good. That is love around shrimp right there. Oh, my gosh, that's good. But wait, there's more. I'm just trying. one daily. I'm just trying to help here. But wait, there's more. I know, I got my ShamWow mic on and the whole thing. Trust me, dude. I got so much crap for having the ShamWow mic. I get it. 100% get it. Expired links, that's an expired. The Rev Lincoln is a 40. It was from March. A little old-fashioned third time. Sorry, I got to read a little bit. It's the way the mic catches your voice. Does sound a bit infomercially. Yeah, I know. Sorry. But it's better than it was. I don't know what to do with it. I mean, I used to run on just the mic here, and it wasn't as good. So, didn't have the last slash. Oh, okay, there you go. That happens. We still love you, Wise Rooster. Don't worry about it, man. You're all right. So, yeah, I get it. It does have a little bit of that that late night after talk show twang thing. So, I'm gonna put the sun-dried tomato seasoning of Newman's Own. I'm going to put the garlic, and I'm going to put the barbecue on the shrimp on what we'd like to call the Barbie, even though it's not a Barbie. Well, it is a Barbie if you go, you know, you travel over to Europe and European countries, and it's called a barbecue. So, and then the steak's about ready to come off. So let me just lay these on. and see how nice they go on there? I have one side of my grill. It's a little warmer than the other. These are not going to take long. These shrimp are going to go toot sweet. So I'm going to pull that steak off and show you guys the steak. We're going to take a bite out of it. And then we're going to get to, I think we're going to unwrap the VacuVita that you guys are all trying to get a chance to win. If you guys want to see that. You guys want to see how it works? If you guys want to see how it works, I'd love to show it to you. Sports commentator. Yeah. Thank you, Outsider. Yeah. I'm not a sports commentator. I don't know much about sports, but I can eat. I can sport eat. I got to tell you there, Pally. Let me tell you. If you'd like, I can do the weather. Partly cloudy, mostly sunny today. High and then at midnight. Yeah. So my mom always said I had a face for radio. Love that lady. So do you guys, I assume you'd like to see me unbox this thing. The one I'm unboxing is mine. The one you're getting, whoever wins, is going to be brand new in the box. So this thing's worth about $400. $399 to be exact. So yeah, I'd like to see. Yeah, me too. LOL, yeah, there you go. Okay, thank you very little. Appreciate that. Hey, if you guys haven't yet, hit the follow button over there. We'd appreciate that. Me appreciate that very much. Let me get my keyboard out of the way. And again, I know some of you aren't Packer fans. I heard about it. And a little bit ago, I heard about it. We are going to have Packer great Super Bowl champ, Packer Hall of Famer, Gilbert Brown here next week on Wednesday cooking with us. Gil's a good guy. He's actually has a pellet grill, believe it or not. And we're doing a big old Zilla steak, a big old Gravezilla steak, and good old number 93. Yeah, boo. Keep your booze to yourself, Outsider. You already booed once. We don't care about you. Go away. I am going to pull the steak out. Well, no, I'm not going to. I'm going to do one quick thing here. And I'm going to show you something. We're going to make a quick packet for... there you go. That was supposed to happen. We're going to make a quick packet. Well, I'm not going to. We're going to make a quick packet for rice. Okay? So if you guys like rice with your shrimp, which I do, I'm going to make a quick pouch for it. So usually you take a square foot or a foot and do this. Just that much. Now I'm going to fold it over again. Okay. I think you guys can see me doing this. And then the end here, that's kind of, oh, I'm going to take these two open ends that are like ugly ends. And I'm going to fold them over and I'm going to make a pouch out of this. Pouches is best. And now, as you can see, und have a pouch. Okay. There's a pouch. Nice pouch. Thank you. Thank you for the pouch. Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit of minute rice in here. Normally, I like really like fresh rice, but I'm going to use a little minute rice. So it's generally one cup of rice to 2 cups of water. So basically, I'm going to do a quarter cup to a half cup because I don't need a lot. I just need enough. So and I don't have a lot in here. So let me do a quarter cup, and then I'm going to get a half cup of water, but I'm not going to use water here. I'm going to use something a little different. That's the whole pitch of this one. So here's a quarter cup of quick rice, okay? And then for something a little different and for added flavors, okay, I'm going to make this more of a lemon rice, a very bright tasting lemon rice. So first we get a little bit of lemon or lime. I'm sorry, lime rice. A little bit of lime. The only thing you need to do is add an inflated man waving his arms. That is, what's the inflated man thing? What is that? Giant inflatable flailing arm tube man. Arm flailing. Giant inflatable arm flailing tube man. That's right. Come on down to the arm flailing. The giant inflate. Giant. What is it? Giant inflatable arm flailing tube man. Come down today where you'll see the giant inflatable arm flailing tube man on my roof. Thank you very little for letting me do that one daily. Okay, now we're going to take, I put a little bit of lime in there, and now guess what I have? I have some margarita mix. No booze in this one, just margarita mix. Let me look a little. Okay, I'll be away. Bye. Okay, don't go anywhere. Buffalo chicken, mozz chicken, I like crack. Yeah, I'll agree with you on that. Do you like, do you prefer wood? I kind of like wood. Frogmat is great. Yep. Monologues are real. Send me a pic. Oh, it has my number. Okay. You guys are talking amongst yourself. That's fine. So I'm going to put a little bit of margarita mix in here. Margarita mix and rice, really. And a couple of good sprays of lime. Yep. That's what I just did. You saw it here first. Don't forget about it. So then what we want to do is seal this puppy up. Okay. And good. The folds you want to do twice, and you want to put it on the grill. Watch this. We're going to put this on the grill, and this is going to take about 15 minutes, maybe about 15 minutes. Let's see how the shrimp are doing, because they're going to come off. I should have done this the same time, but I didn't. So let's put that on the grill. Shrimp are getting there. They're not quite done yet. I have the grill on 260, people. Just so you know, I have it on 260 degrees. The actual temp is 260 degrees. So, and again, the pellets we're using are 100% hickory tonight. Usually I use a perfect mix, but the hickory will give me a little bit of flavor, a little bit more flavor in a shorter amount of time. I won't worry about using a true 100% hickory on this because I'm not going to oversmoke anything. If I used it on a really long cook, I could oversmoke. So anyway, there's my commercial. Okay. And I'm just trying to clean up a little bit so it doesn't turn into just a complete mess when I get off of there. There we go. Okay, where are we at? Where's all the food? So our steak is about done. And let's see, told you about Gil. To recap, we did a little bit of, those are 16-20 shrimp. So 16-20 per pound. Grilled cheese, you know, stainless kebab. I don't like stainless. Good cheese dripping out. Okay. So any pictures, I'd love to see a picture. Wise Rooster, if you guys want to post something, just try posting at Wise Rooster or ask Wise Rooster. He'll give you a little okie dokie. Anyway, so to recap here real quick, we had a couple shrimp and had a couple shrimp that were in a vacuum bag, which I think you guys might have missed. We had one of these. This is like a $20 vacuumer, and the bag kind of lost it. You hear that? There you go. And you take that, you put it up against the little blue dot there, and it sucks all the air out. Not the best in the West, which is why I got what I got. So, and I'll share with you guys as soon as we open it here shortly. And it's a beast. It's big. Anyway, so we put two in there with some olive oil. Our garlic roasted rosemary infused olive oil that we did. And then I took some seasoning from Carbecue Seasonings and I used their lemon garlic seasoning and mixed it with their, and then put it in the, marinated it for about 15 minutes. Those are on. That's the two on the very far right. Then we had a couple of barbecue ones, just barbecue sauce, chicken, barbecue sauce. Pat them all dry before you put anything on them, makes it stick better. And then the other one was an Italian seasoning, a sun-dried tomato Italian seasoning, a Newman's, and really good stuff. So it'll just be a little bit different, differenter than you think. Tasty Morsel, thanks so much for swinging by. I really appreciate it. The rest of you, I'm going to unbox this vacuum thing shortly, so don't go anywhere, and you'll be able to see what it looks like. your vac, thank you very much. Vac Vita sucks. Thank you so very little. What's your favorite food to smoke? Tasty Morsel, by the way, thanks so much. Go, you guys that don't know, go check out her stream. She does great work. My favorite thing, I have a bunch, really. I love cooking breakfast on my pellet grill, pancakes on it. My wife's banana chocolate chip muffin recipe is really good on the grill. I like pulled pork. Pheasant. I shoot, and when I shoot pheasant, I bring it home. Don't do it a lot, but it's fresh, and we eat. In fact, they had pheasant tenderloin
last night. And it was off the hook. And actually, I was late last night and didn't have it. I was not happy, but I had a couple pieces when I got home. So it was very, very good. I'm starting the warming drawer so we can get some on. Let me go get the meat off of here. Smoke cooking pellets. That's it. Night all. Thank you so much again. We really appreciate it, Tasty Morsel. You guys, again, hook up. Go check out her stuff. She does a great job. Now I'll talk. Yeah, steak. So we got to do a little steak. Now, just because you may not like shrimp, you got to try shrimp when it's not overcooked. That's the key thing. When shrimp isn't overcooked, there you go. Look at that. They're just starting to get white here. And I'm just going to, you don't need to turn them, but you can tell they get a little pink. They're almost done. This is not going to take more than another minute or two. You can see this is puffing up in there, and the steak is finished. I'm going to leave these in. That's only going to take another 2 minutes for those shrimp. They are almost perfect. I don't know if you could tell what it looked like. Could you guys tell that the aluminum foil was starting to puff up a little bit on the grill cam? Ooh, I got to tell you, that is juicy. That is super juicy. Young man, would you like to take a try? This is steak. What do you think it is? I know you will. Okay, oh, look at that. This is done. This is medium rare. Medium rare. I got to show you on the ingredients cam here on what it looks like. Give me a second here to put that up. I got to find the right camera. I'm sorry. So there you go. Look at, oh, it's not getting in there. Hold on. There we go. So you can barely tell the smoke. Well, it still didn't get in. I'm trying to get it to, come on. It's not focusing good, but you get the idea. So there is a little bit of pink overall on the edge that is smoked, okay? And let me tell you, this, I got to cut two pieces, one for me and one for the tester extraordinaire. There you go, tester extraordinaire. And one for me, I have to try this. No, it's not soft. Oh, that, I got to tell you, that's pretty good. Now, Chuck, this is like Chuck steak. And oh, that's really good. You can taste the Worcestershire, and remember, this was vacuum sealed. Excuse me. Oh man, that's good. This was vacuum sealed for probably a good 24 hours, and it is super flavorful. You can taste the garlic, little hint of garlic in there. Oh my gosh, what is this? He says. That's a big box. This is what somebody's going to get. This. Enter the contest. This is what you're going to receive. So, wow. Super flavorful. We put Worcestershire in there. Easy for me to say. A little balsamic vinegar. About an eighth of a cup each. And then, again, my garlic-infused rosemary olive oil for a day in the vacuum bag. That is awesome. The shrimp have to come off. I don't want to overdo the shrimp because that is not good. Let me grab the shrimp and put them. In fact, I don't need that. Let me go grab the shrimp, okay? This is what we're going to be giving away. If you guys haven't looked there yet, it's cookinpellets.com/contest. And go ahead and enter the contest. So here you go. This is starting. Look at that. You see the pink on this? That is hot. So this is, I'm going to give this just a little mix here. So that right there, let me put this over to the side just a little hotter. That is right above boiling, obviously, and that rice should take about another 5 or 10 minutes Boy, and I hate to give you all these off, just show you all these before they're done, but take a look at that. So we have the ones on the, boy, that doesn't even show real good, does it? There you go. We have the barbecue, we have the Italian dressing, and then we have the garlic infused that were marinated for about 15 minutes. So what I'm going to do is drop these in the warming drawer, and we have, and I don't know if you guys have one, this, I never thought I'd use it, and I had the opportunity to pull a drawer out and put one in, and it's awesome. Thank you so much. Yummy? Yes, it is, Sunshell. Very yummy. So, and it's very good. Just super, super tasty. Let me pull off the auto. The autofocus is driving me up a wall. There we go. Hello. So, and for those of you that don't know, I am the Reverend of Barbecue. This is Cooking Pellets. And if you haven't yet, get us a follow. We do this every Wednesday at 7 o'clock and every Saturday at 10 a.m. And that's Central Time. Warming drawer. Yes, sir. Warming drawer, steak and shrimp. Yeah, see, and it is. Oh, let me put the steak in there, too. A warming drawer is just that. It's just an electric insulated box. That's all it is. It's just that. And you just take out a drawer and put it in place of it. It's 110 volts. It's very simple. There's nothing to it. It's a little insulated, but we entertain. We like to have a lot of family over. So when I do stuff like off the grill, that thing right there, it's always nice to have a place to put warm stuff. And I don't always like using the oven. I'm not a big oven guy. I just don't do it. We have a brand new, kebabble right there. And that is what we use. That's our oven. And we use it for everything. Last Christmas, I did an apple and a pumpkin pie. Believe that. So, downtown, and I can only use my barbecue. What's your advice for smoking with a gas grill? Okay. Glad you asked. So what I do, if you have a gas or charcoal grill, that's a great question. Thank you so much for asking. Stickler 911, and welcome to the kitchen and to the grilling area. So this is what we do. We actually sell, I gotta refresh my stuff here, I'm sorry, because it didn't come through. We sell 3-pound sample bags on our site, and I'm not giving you a pitch, I'm just telling you. So for those of you that have a charcoal or a gas grill, you don't need a 40-pound bag of pellets if you don't have a pellet grill. I get that. So we have our pellets in a small bag, and what you do is you take like a third of a cup. Let's say you want to get a lot of smoke into something, but you're not going to smoke 12, 14 hours on your gas grill. I get that. So let's say you got burgers on, okay, or chicken. So your normal temp, drop it back a little bit because you're going to leave it on just a little longer. So drop your temp back. If you're usually doing your chicken around 300 degrees, I know on charcoal it's a little hard to figure, but you got to get used to a little bit of temperature range here. So on your gas grill, charcoal grill, keep it around 300, 325 if that's what you're used to. Sometimes people just crank it up and throw it on. So you got to get out of that if you want to get some good smoke flavor in it. You got to get away from that. So what I would do is I would get about a half a cup of pellets, or a third of a cup, I'm sorry, pour it into some heavy-duty aluminum foil, okay? So you got a big sheet of aluminum foil here, maybe an 8x8. You pour it into that. You go ahead and you make a nice, tight ball with it, okay? You go ahead and you make a ball out of the pellets. Use the aluminum foil to make the ball with. If it breaks through, just make a couple of pieces around. It's not going to hurt it. Then you take one hole and you poke the hole in the top, okay? One hole in that ball about the size of your pinky, and then go ahead and set that by the heat source. So, like, this is a heat source. Don't put it on the grill. You got to get by the heat source. You got to get it to start smoking. And when it starts smoking, throw the food on, turn the grill down a little bit, and then let that thing smoke with the food on it for a good half an hour. And you're going to taste tons of smoke. And not overly smoke, but you're going to taste a really good smoke flavor there. So that's, we call that a smoke bomb. That's a cooking pellet smoke bomb. And you can use that with either one of our pellets that we have. The hickory is going to get you a little bit more out of it. When the smoke bomb's done smoking, just leave it there. Don't touch it until it cools off. But that's how you do that. I mean, neighbors are going to call maybe, go, well, what's wrong? Did you start the place on fire? No, it's just tons of smoke. Trust me. That's a really good way to do it. And there you go. So that's on a gas or charcoal grill, either one. So let's go ahead and open this box up. And we're going to try, we're going to get the rice. I didn't forget about the rice. I want to give it enough time to cook. You can't really overcook rice much. I suppose you can, but. Oh, pretty packaging. So, again, this is a vacuum sealer. If you guys are coming in late, we're giving them one of these away. If you haven't followed us yet, follow us. But we're given, oh, look at that, can't see you. We're given one of these, I have a monitor right here, that's why I keep on looking down and I read chat. So, anyway, so when you guys get a chance, go ahead and give us a follow. We appreciate that. Do the, you know, look on the Facebook and the Instagram and the YouTube. All our stuff's on YouTube usually a day later. And all our other shows are up there, so you can go back and check there. And I have a question. If any of you other guys, anybody else that's out there, if you are, if you're streamers, let me know. Go, you know, you can go ahead and, you know, raise your hand, put a number one by your name if you're a streamer, because we like to do shout-outs and let other people know what's going on. So these are vacuum bags. It says keeps your foods fresh for up to 5 times longer. So somebody else earlier had asked, why would I want a vacuum sealer? And it just to keep your food fresher longer other than using it for marinating. So Nita, O2, how you doing? Thanks for swinging by. Appreciate that very much. Welcome to the grill. Welcome to the kitchen. We're unboxing a gift that one of you guys are going to win, something that one of you guys are going to win. So we're unboxing a Vacuvita, and it's a vacuum system, a food storage system, vacuum system. So these say they're suitable for freezer and sous vide cooking. I don't know if any of you guys ever do sous vide. Am I saying that correctly? Sous vide. Streamer roll call. Yeah, streamer roll call. USS Firefly, really? What do you do? Drop us. Let us know. Detail. Thank you very much, Stickler. I appreciate that. They do. And you know what? Honestly, we're going to sell you a 3-pound bag for $7. We're not making a dime on it, really. It's just to get the word out, and it's for customers to try it and see if they like it for their pellet grill. But a little insight for you guys that have gas and charcoal, really it's the cheapest you're going to find out there. So for 3 pounds of pellets, and they're quality pellets. I mean, you know, I can honestly talk till I'm blue in the face, but if you guys don't have a dealer by you and you're looking, you can go to, you can go up to Amazon, which by the way, we're the highest rated and the best seller on Amazon for 4 years. So that's gotta mean something other than me telling you. So this looks like it's a container set, and this is bigger than a bread box or about the size of one. Okay, let me throw this bag away, or that box away. Wow, that is a big dog. With food sealer, it must be, it pushes the marinade into the food, so it's much better than having you. Yes, 100%. And you know what I want to do is I am going to try one of these shrimp. I wanted it to cool off just a little bit, even though it's in the warming drawer. I wanted it to cool off just a little bit. So, G? Mrs. Becker! Looking for the Mrs. B! Boy, I got to tell you. Just starting, going to focus on baking. Oh, very cool, USS Firefly. Very cool. So, go ahead and, if you have, your, you know, obviously it's twitch.tv//USSFirefly, I assume. And, if you know when you're going to be on, love to see you. Follow him, as I will. That would be awesome.
And what else? And our Petra, I know he hosts. I've seen him host. Or stream, I'm sorry, stream. Give me a second. I am going to grab somebody because somebody wanted to try some shrimp. Mrs. B. Hello. Where is the Mrs. B? You wanted to try shrimp? Yeah, okay. Don't step on that. Can you please pick that up? Thank you very much. There you go. Okay. I have the troublemaker coming. Let's see. Who picked out? I think tonight's kitchen color was brought to us by Weeping Ostrich, if I'm not wrong. Correct, guys? Weeping Ostrich. Sorry I had to leave there for a second. We are going to try some shrimp. Hold on a sec. Her. Sorry, USS Firefly. Her, I assume, is her. I am so sorry. And I'm burning myself. I've done this once already, and you'd think I'd learn. I'm sorry, USS Firefly. Her, I should have known better. I'm so sorry. Your humble reverend. Okay. So we are going to do, are you going to try some? Dude. Yeah. Just try a little piece. You got to try a little piece, buddy. Yeah, but you don't know that because you haven't had any yet. Okay, so this is here. Barbecue. Yes? Okay, so I got a yeah, that's good. Here. It's like chicken tenders. I'll give you props for doing it, Pally. So my 13-year-old is quite the picky eater. But I'm going to give him $1.380 when I get off of the stream here cuz he tried that. So okay, thank you. Ships usually women. Oh, yeah, duh. Okay, I should have known better. Yeah, I know. The autofocus thing. I actually turned this one off, autofocus, and it's still a little back and forth on me. Okay. Here's another one. This is the lemon garlic shrimp. Mrs. B likes lemon garlic. Well, she likes shrimp. That's good. That was really good. Lemon garlic. Our garlic, roasted garlic infused rosemary olive oil with some lemon garlic salt. Or seasoning, I should say. Woo! That's good. I don't know if it's because of the two cams. It might be. But I have the grill cam out there, too. Usually it doesn't... If I go ahead and I get this cam over here, that's my ingredients cam. If I get that set to go on, then if there's something in the background, it goes back and forth. Yeah, look at that. It's just going. And I think it's because of these. Yeah, it's doing it right now. Anyway. Oh, okay. So, and then the last one. Did you hear me tell you what the last one was? No. I'm going to try this, and then I'm going to give it to her. And, you know, that's always a worrisome thing for her. Oh, super light. I'm not giving you $10, pal. Five. You already tasted the shrimp. Five. Sun-dried tomato Italian seasoning. That's pretty good, huh? What do you want more of? Here's the barbecue. Can you eat this? This is really good for you to eat. This one? Okay, that's the garlic one. Really? You're going to have the garlic? She usually doesn't need that much garlic. I'm surprised. So anyway, sorry to eat, but point is, the shrimp, and I don't know who doesn't like shrimp. I mean, I know some people don't dig it, but it is so fresh. And if you can get the outer skin, which you probably can't tell on this piece, you can. I don't know if you can see that pink. Well, you can't. The camera's not real good, but there's a pink around there. You know, the outside color gets a little pink. Man, it is just all good.
Yeah, milking a dad for some cash, I'm telling you. Our little bugger. He did it backwards, though. Okay. Yeah, I know you would, outsider. I believe that 100%. All right, are we going to finish? Yes, you guys sign up on this. Do you want another piece? You sure? Okay. Last one, there. All right, this has got to go back in the drawer. We got to open this and look at it. Okay, sorry. So, here's a container kit. So, this thing comes with a bunch of containers. He'll learn. Yeah, he will. He will, R. He will, R. Patrick. He will. So, we have some tops. And it looks like they have something you can stick something on there with. Soon, yeah. We hope he'll learn soon. This is a white one, I see. This is just pure white. The whole thing is just white. So we got a bunch of, let me just empty this out. We got a bunch of containers. And now I assume when you draw the vacuum on this, let me put this over here. I assume when you draw the vacuum on this that... that you can put fresh stuff in here. I don't know if you can put bags in here too. Maybe you can. He is pretty tasty to get those smoky, tasty morsel treat. I got to tell you, he loves my pulled pork, but he has tasted things. I did, for the first time, I did fresh pheasant on the grill, and I didn't tell them what it was. And when they asked, I said, it's just a different kind of chicken. And they looked at me crooked, and everybody loved it, and I told it was pheasant. If I would have said pheasant ahead of time, they wouldn't. In fact, it tasted like pork. I don't know why. What? Oh, he still would have tried it, he says. He's moving up. He's getting to be so old. An old soul he is. Getting to be so old. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, buddy. So, you can see we have a bunch of containers. We have... Oh, boy. We have four boxes. Okay, I'm just looking at it, see if there's anything in there. We have four boxes of, or two boxes of bags, two large boxes of bags. And now here's the contraption that makes it all work together. Okay, tells you about how much food you save by using it. Fresh, you can get more of these and put them in. I did not brine first. The shrimp, I did not brine. Most shrimp are, well, stuff I can read. most shrimp, since they're seafood, I don't use a lot of salt in what I cook. And because of that, I'm not a big salt guy. So I don't generally add salt to much of anything. So, like, usually the marinades are salty enough for me to season. So I don't brine. In fact, I generally don't brine anything. Watch what I'm doing here, folks, because you might have to do the same thing if you win this. And not this one, but a brand new one in the box. There we go. Oopsie, as I'm going to start a fire. Okay. Hi, young lady. How are you? Glad. Huh? Okay. Can't you do it somewhere else? Go ahead. So, thank you. Okay, so, in here, let me take this off. Yeah, this thing's kind of big. And I don't know, do you guys brine? I mean, I know a couple of you have pellet grills. It's irrelevant whether you have a pellet grill or not. But if you brine, do you brine before you do, like, turkey? Do you do a turkey on the grill? Have you ever done a turkey on the grill? Have you ever had a turducken? Let me see a show of hands on that one. A turducken. Whew, look at these puppies. We have vacuum. These are big bags. Look at the size of that. That's a big bag. I mean, you can put a lot of food in that bag. These are the large. Okay, then what are these? These say large bags. Oh, there's 15 of them in here. This must be extra. And they're still good for sous vide. And, yeah, you do. Our
Our Patter. Well, you know, our Patra, you, oh, you Brian Salmon. Well, that makes sense. Our Patra, you actually work in a restaurant, correct? I think he works in a restaurant, if I remember correctly. You work in a restaurant, and are you the chef in the restaurant? Or sous chef, or what? And Salmon, yeah. I'm generally not a big Salmon guy. I missed out. My grill had an issue. That little bugger had an issue, and I couldn't do I had King Salmon from Alaska that was fresh, and I couldn't cook it. I had to give it away. Ooh, I was not happy. Yeah, I do. I do. Far from it. Well, but you work in a restaurant, right? Yeah, you work in a restaurant. Come on, don't call me a liar. Don't call me out a liar here. Okay, that let me get the rest of this out here. So this does a little bit of everything, I guess. Ooh, that's got some weight to it. Okay. So I think the attachment that's on here, let me put this away, sorry. Let me put these bags over here to get them out of my way. This obviously works with this, and this looks like the top attachment for these. You work in a large hotel, 500, that's a damn big hotel, dang. Yeah, that's a lot of hotel. So again, if you guys are just joining us, do us a favor, give us a follow. We're doing an unboxing right now of a Vacuvita, and we're gonna be giving one of these puppies away. So you gotta enter the contest to get one, but we give you multiple chances to do it. So this goes on top of this, and this hose goes in this, and then it goes into this, kind of to use these as a vacuum device. So let me take off. I got to tell you, it's very well packaged for what it is. Let me move it over here so you guys can see it. There you go. I hope that's a little better. Actually, why don't we move these over here, because they're not doing nothing. Sorry about that. Okay. And okay, very, very nicely packaged. Don't remember where they were made. I know it's, I don't want to say Sweden or somewhere, but okay. Remove all packaging material before use for proper function of product. Open the lid and remove the transparent protective foil from the metal plate on the vacuum brand. Okay, so I don't know if this opens. You know, I suppose directions are a good thing right now because I can't get it to open. I don't suppose you'd want to get me a bottle of grape juice, do you? Yeah, downstairs. Bottle of grape juice. Okay. Place the home base on a flat surface. Plug it in. Ha! Ha ha ha! There's always technical difficulties with plugs. Plug it in, she said. Okay. Made in China. Is it really, Outsider? I don't know if it is, pal. And maybe it is. You might be right. I might be wrong. Let me see. I'm going to look at the box here. It's got a color. Maybe it was designed. Ow. Maybe it was designed. It's UL approved. Blah, blah, blah. Doesn't say. Hold on. I'm going to. Ooh, not that. That's really. Not that one. That's really good. You can get a bottle of CS. You want to share a bottle of CS with me? You want to share. Well, get something out of Cameron Hughes. How's that? Is that okay? She's. I can't do it. Sorry, kids. Okay, there we go. We should be. There we go. Hello. There we go. We're back. No, she's not looking for the batteries. I have a plug right here, but I have so much crapola in it that it's not working so well. So you guys should hear. You're back. I'm back now, right? Give me a thumbs up. There you go. Thank you. So I got to put this somewhere else now. I'm going to put this. Where can I put this? I don't have a plug. Dang it all. I didn't count on this one. Hold on. Let me go get a. Yep. Thank you. I know I got. I got audio. Oh, there we go. A nice 597. Let me go get an extension cord real quick. I didn't count on this one. I'm sorry, everybody. But you can walk with me if you don't mind. We're around and to and fro and in between and by there. Let's see. Let's go out in the garage. Hello, garage. And let us find a small device for plugging into other device eye. That would be this. Okay. Okay, so this is probably four times longer than it needs to be, but in a pinch, she'll work. Okay. There you go. I'll make this work one way or the other. Never say never. Never say never, kids. There we go. Let's plug her in over here, see if we can blow up something. All right. Hi. I'm back. Sorry about that. You know, it's what makes it interesting, don't it? Okay, and I don't think I have anything on the grill. I think everything I was going to do I cooked, and I didn't want to have any extra on the grill while I did this. I should probably check, huh? Why don't we check, just to make sure. I think I pulled off my steak. I think I pulled off my marinated and my seasoned shrimp, which, by the way, people, fresh shrimp works just as good. But, oh, look at that. You're right. I forgot about my, Who's the smart guy? Cheese and crackers. See, this is what happens when you throw stuff in at the last second. So thank you. Who did that? Who said that? Not enough grape juice. Semph. Thank you, sir. Semph67. He saved me, but I don't think I've burnt the rice. The one nice thing about a pellet grill is it's really hard to burn stuff because it's all indirect heat. There you go. Giant and flailing funny tube arm mat. Okay. And let's put that nice packet of love. Well, look at that. Look at that starting to go down. See that starting to crush in from the heat? Let's put that off. We're going to bring this in. And let's see if we got... Let's see what kind of steam we got. We're going to have to open it up. See what kind of grilled steam we got. Grilled rice. I'm going to put this over to the side here real quick. Let me open that up. Let me open this right here so you can see it. Wait. Oh, did you hear that? God, it sounded like something out of Star Trek. Oh, my God. No shrimp and margarita mix. This was just our rice. This was nothing more than rice. That's what we have in here. And it's going to be hot when I open it, so let's all be careful. I was going to eat. Look at that. It's perfect. Let me get a clean plate, though, because that plate just got goobered up from the grill. Actually, we'll put it in a ramekin. And then remember, folks, there was not a lot of rice in here to start with. It was only about a quarter cup. So now you could do more rice, obviously. I use the margarita mix on this. Ooh, that's good and done. It's good and sticky, too. And that was instant rice, so that probably sat in there 8,000 times longer than needed. Let me just scrape her down. Yeah, now I got to tell you, it smells awesome. So this is only a quarter cup of rice with a little bit of margarita mix, about a half cup of margarita mix. And then... And we use some lime juice, not lemon, but lime juice, because lime juice is a much brighter taste, if that makes sense. Love lime juice. And you guys steal this from me. By all means, give it a try. That's why we're here. Jeez, I'd be just impressed if somebody else said that they try it and it was good. And it's a little sticky. Hell, I made sticky rice. What do you know? It's a little sticky because it was on the grill a little long. But, okay, hold on. Oh, wow. Hey, Tasty, you're back. How you doing? We just opened up our margarita rice. There, another firstie. The Reverend of Barbecue made margarita rice on the grill. Now, let me tell you, this stuff rocks. Oh, this with the shrimp? Wow. This is unbelievable. Wow, is that... Oh, my gosh, is that so fresh. I am so happy I tried that. Okay. This is going like this. There you go. So, we have our sun-dried tomato Italian dressing shrimp with our margarita rice. Yeah, you heard it here first, people. Margarita rice. And we're going to get back to the Vacu Vita in a second here. But I got to try this with the rice. My God, is this good. Moo Moo, come here. Moo Moo. Sorry, people. Wow, that is so good. U.S. Firefly, thank you so much for swinging by. I really do appreciate it very much. If you haven't, please give us a follow. Go try to win this thing. Okay, on the website, go try and win this. It's rice. It's not shrimp. What do you think of that? Oh, I got bright eyes from that. That's good, huh? You like it? Yeah? She's giving me a big bright eye, and well, maybe I might. You know, she never likes anything I like. I do. Well, I shouldn't say that. She likes most of it. Isn't for 2 months. Yeah, the giveaway isn't for 2 months, but if you sign up early, you get extra stuff because we're going to roll that back a little bit, just so you know. And we're going to give followers extra stuff. So as we go down. Anyway. Oh, okay. R, thanks so much for swinging by. You guys check him out, R. Patra. He's got a really good stream. He cooks in his kitchen like I do, and he does a lot of really cool stuff. A little bit more involved than I get in mine because I do grills. So anyway, thanks for swinging by, man. Really appreciate it. Go follow him. U.S. Firefly, even though it's 2 months, we're doing it that long because we're trying to give, you know, everybody kind of an equal chance. Look at, I only got like 135 followers, and I'm trying to build my follower base. Plus, I have a lot of people on the Instagram and social media stuff that also follows us. So we're doing kind of a different thing on that. But anyway, it's out a little bit, but don't let that, you know, new cars aren't given away in a day. So I'm upfront about it. So anyway, so here you go. Here's the Vacu Vita thing. And it's really damn cool. So I'm going to go ahead and put this container in it just to see what it does. Oh, my gosh. This thing is so odd. So I'm going to put this container in it just to. Now, they say you can do this. So let's leave it go. And now it's supposed to seal the container, which is cool. You can use it with the other thing, I guess. I'm glad you entered today, U.S. Thank you, and thanks so much for stopping by. We'll check out your stuff. Come back by and tell us when you start streaming, and we'll go and follow you. So you guys, she's going to start streaming, doing bakery and stuff and kitchen stuff and cooking, and go follow her right now. And then when she starts streaming, at least we'll go ahead and we'll be on board from the get-go, which is really cool. So they are giving away in 2 days. What's giving away? Two people to win center. 2 months to enter. Yeah, sorry. I'm just reading through. Okay, so, boy, if you push this, it's like, whoosh, and then it opens. This thing's like a little Hollywood thing. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's sealed. That is sealed. Let me tell, wait.
Okay, I don't know how to unseal it.
Oh, okay. Scared me. So you lift up the corner here and it unseals it. But let me tell you, that's a tight, I mean, the sides are actually in on this. That's a really tight seal. There you go. So if you want to put liquids in here and keep liquids good and long, you can do it that way. I think this must be for the bag. Oh, it's for the bags. Oh, I get it. Okay, let's play with the bags, shall we, real quick? Out of way and over the giveaway, I'll tell all the boys at work to go sign up and follow as well. Thank you. If you go to cookinpellets.com, and Wise Rooster, if you're out there, he can throw the link up. I don't know if I can go back through and find it. I'll look real actually, I might be able to do this. Let me see if it's there. Oops. Right here. Ask and thou shalt receive. There you go, young man. Or ma'am. Or whichever it may be. Stickler 99. Sorry if I'm insulting. Don't mean to be. So that is the link right there. And just follow the directions. It's pretty simple. So here, I'm going to show you how well this goes. Here's a, this is a sweet tater that I was going to use tonight and didn't. But I'm going to put it in here. We're going to seal this up, okay? And let me put it on another surface that we can see a little bit better. Let me use this surface right here. Okay, and you can see how fluffy that is. Oops. Okay. And this goes on here. So, and they kind of give you fill lines of how full it can be, so you don't, you know, overfill the stuff and make a mess. Thank you, Wise Rooster, for posting that. Appreciate it. And let's see where this, I think, goes in the back here, if I'm not wrong. And God knows I've been wrong. So let's put this in here. And then okay, and it's got a little LED light on the top. Very cool. I think you can see that right there. And then we're just going to place this over this. And is that right? Maybe not. I might not have this correct. Hold on. I might not have done that. Oh, you know I didn't. Therefore I am. Don't know what that's for. Oh, I know what that's for. That, I think if you take this out, that's what seals. Let's check this and see if that's what seals this. Nope. Nope. Okay, now I got to read directions. Now I got to read directions. Boy, I tell you, I hate when that happens. Come on. I wonder if I could put this in here. Think if I put this in here, it'll draw the air out of it? We're going to find out in a second, aren't we? So let's leave it sit, and then let's just see what it says for using it. Oh, here you go. Place the thing in the food, blah, blah, blah. Touch the center LED light. Rings on top of the home base, activate the vacuum processor, and firmly press down the vacuum adapter. Okay, so I got to plug this in to here. Okay, so I got it now. So let's take this out of here. And you know what? It really didn't take any air out of there, and I don't doubt that it wouldn't. So let's push this in here. Oh, that's why the light comes on top. Okay. So it says, touch the center of the LED rings. Make sure the vacuum adapter is on here. It just takes me a little bit, people. Sorry. Helps to read directions, I guess. Oh, my gosh. Look at that. Okay. I guess I don't have it on there good enough. Wait a second. Oh, I screwed it up. Hold on, people. Okay.
I think I got to take all the air out of the bag I can, because it's only going to do it as much as possible, or as little as possible, I'm betting. Bear with me. Let me try this again. Maybe I didn't seal it all the way. Ooh, that's a tight seal. All right, one more time here. There we go. There we go. Now it's starting. Can you see that? Watch. That is a very tough seal. Look at that. Here, let me show you. Let me show you over here on the ingredients cam. Look at this. Look at that. That thing is like right up against, it's like one extra skin. So there you go. That is the VacuVita, and that thing just sealed that thing, and this is supposed to last like five times long. Look at that. I mean, that did take all the air out. That is amazing. So if you needed stuff to last five times longer, if you need to marinate meats, that's it. And you know what? We're not doing an infomercial here. Today and only today, $29.99. Ha! So there you go. So there's your VacuVita. I'm going to come back to this in 40 years, and it's going to be perfect. And let's open up. This reminds me, I don't know if they're here. I'm going to date myself. Dr. Fibes. This is somebody's coffin here. Watch. Oh, I love that. Look at that. That's just, I got to do that again. I got to do that again on my main camera, because that's just so silly of me. Hold on. Let me get over here, peeps. Wise Rooster 69. I don't know if we have anybody we can chit-chat with or anybody that's on. I don't know if Drew is on. Who's on? Watching. Drew's not up. Tasty Morsel's up doing stuff. Ichabod, you're still around here. How you doing, buddy? Thanks for swinging by. Ichabod Glass is a streamer also. And why am I watching an ad for VAC? Because I'm going to give it away. Damn Twitch. Because I'm giving it away to you. That's why. It's not Twitch. It's me doing it. So there. We're going to do it again. There you go. Okay. So you're not watching that. I'm just showing it to you. I'm unboxing. I'm showing you what you're going to win. Really, that's what it boils down to. So, Butt Outsider. That's, come on now, man. Iggy's up. Okay, we can go pester Iggy. You guys, Iggy is a, I'm going to host over to Iggy, and I want you guys to follow me. He does wood, let me get rid of this. He does wood turning, Iggy does, and he does a really nice job, actually. He does some pretty cool stuff. So if you guys want to follow me over, I really appreciate everybody that swung by today and stayed with us. Really appreciate Tasty Morsel. And bringing everybody over. All you guys, thanks so much for this. Swinging by. We really appreciate it. We can't do it without you guys watching. And we're at the utmost of appreciation. And, you know, that's the way it goes. So I'm going to go ahead and let me see. Give me a second here so I can find the everlasting Ignatius, actually. Please just swing over for a little bit. Show your love to Ignatius, from us. We appreciate that very much. Let me get his stream. Hold on 1 second so I can go back to my dash. Give me 1 second here, people. And here we go. Hi, sorry about that. Actually, it is... So we're going to raid Iggy. Just tell him that you came over from us. And there's his stuff. We really appreciate it. Wise Rooster 69, I appreciate you very much. Saturday, we got all kinds of stuff coming up. Swing by Saturday, 10 a.m. We're over here at 7 a.m. And next week is Gilbert Brown from the Green Bay Packers, 7 a.m. Wednesday. Swing on by with us. We're giving this thing away down the road. And until then, thanks so much for hanging out. And we really do appreciate it. Let's go see what Iggy's doing. And until Saturday, hasta la bye-bye.